The assault on the west side of the fort is victorious. After several hours of horrendous hand-to-hand combat, the rebels call it quits, with only a small contingent retreating to Fort Buchanan. It doesn't take long for them to surrender as well. Wilmington, North Carolina is taken within weeks. Once supplies to the Confederacy are cut, the end is in sight for the Confederacy. In the spring of 1865, as Southern forces suffer large casualties and a draining of supplies and resources, General James Wilson hopes to deliver a knockout blow in Selma. His plan is to capture and destroy the large Confederate arsenal there and draw away Nathan Bedford Forrest from Mobile. Major General Forrest is the war's most daring and colorful commander. No man is more feared by the North, except perhaps Robert E. Lee himself. Forrest gathers his forces to defend Selma. On April 1st, Wilson's advance guard meets Forrest's forward line at Ebenezer Church on the crossroads before the city. An intense standoff takes place at the outer works of the city.
Offensive on the city is about to begin. Don't let us down.
give you cover, buddy. You gotta move through them trees and meet up with them. Don't worry now about me. You just do it.
Show me the note, soldier. The assault is about to begin? Very well. My men should already be in the city doing their work. That's it! Prepare yourselves, men! We have destroyed their warehouse. This means no ammo or weapons anymore. Victory's ours! Attack!
Finally, Selma's fortifications fall. General Wilson himself leads a mounted charge forward. After a day of vicious combat, Selma is in the hands of the Union. In the darkness, the Confederates flee. Badly wounded, General Forrest barely escapes by swimming across the Alabama River. Even Nathan Forrest cannot stop the inevitable. With their main manufacturing centers of Atlanta now captured and Richmond in its last throes, Confederate soldiers worry more about feeding themselves than making war.